Good morning. So today we are starting your microwave lab. Okay, in your microwave lab your first experiment is reflex klystron characteristics. So in your reflex klystron characteristics, your microwave bench setup, this is your microwave bench setup. Click it on. So this is your klystron power supply. Okay, klystron power supply. If you are seeing here you are having different modes, say continuous, you are having AM mode, you are having FM mode, you are having external. So here continuous, suppose if you are going for continuous, then we will unable to calculate the output voltage and frequency. We can go for AM, amplitude modulation. Okay. If we are going for FM, we'll get the slotted output, so we can neglect this FM also. External, we are using it if we are having some external say circuit, and if you want to test those external circuit, then we'll put it in external. Okay, so at present we'll put it in AM, amplitude modulation. So you are having the klystron power supply. Klystron power supply, this is your klystron mount, this is your klystron mount, and here we are using fan. Fan is for cooling purpose. If you are seeing here, here as we are selecting the amplitude modulation, here you are having the amplitude and frequency of amplitude modulation. You can increase or decrease the amplitude, you can change the frequency. Similarly, here you are having the amplitude and frequency for frequency modulation. As we are not using frequency modulation, these two knobs we will not use. You are having beam and repeller. So you are knowing that in case of your reflex klystron characteristics, you are having beam voltage and repeller voltage. So here at present it is showing the beam voltage. So we will increase the beam voltage. So whenever we are changing it, here it will show the voltage and current. Okay, the voltage and current. So we can keep it say at 250 levels. Okay, so once if we are keeping the beam voltage at 250, we'll just keep as it is. Okay, now we are not going for changing the beam voltage. Okay, then here you are having the repeller voltage. So now we can, if I'm pressing it, then I can change the repeller voltage. So here by adjusting this, I can change. Here you are seeing the repeller voltage is changing. So voltage and current of the repeller voltage you are seeing. Okay, now in order to have the proper waveform, we will change the beam voltage and the repeller voltage such that we should get the output on CRO. Okay, so here we have adjust the beam voltage at say 250 levels. High tension, will keep it in on state. Okay, here you are having external mode. External mode means if we are testing some external kit, then here we have to keep it in external, and that here we have to connect it those kit. So here as we are not going for any external kit, no need for going this. Okay, we have made it at 250. You can keep it anything, you can keep say till 300 you can keep. Okay, so this is your DC voltage, this is your DC voltage. So 250 volt DC or 300 volt DC, our intention is to get the waveform on the output. Okay, detector mount. So from here you are having the microwave signal. As the microwave signal is, we cannot see the microwave signal directly in the CRO. So for that purpose, we are going for your amplitude modulation. So we are modulating the microwave so that we can see the output on the CRO. Maximum 20 megahertz signal can be seen. So that whatever the frequency, whatever your microwave frequency signal is there, that we are amplitude modulated to a lower frequency. Okay, and then we can see it there. So what that is of your microwave frequency. Now let us see that what are the different blocks that we are having. this is your detector mount. In detector mount you are having the reflex klystron oscillator, and fan is we are using it for cooling purpose. After this, this you are having the oscillator. Sorry, this is isolator. The function of the isolator is that whatever the signal is generated, it will just throw all the signal in one direction. There will not be any reflected wave. So from your reflex klystron oscillator, whatever the signal is generated, all the signal will pass through it in one direction only. After that, here you are having the variable attenuator. So initially we will keep the variable attenuator at minimum position. So this is minimum range. We have just opened it. This is the minimum attenuation. Minimum attenuation means we are not putting any resistance to it. Okay, frequency meter. This is your direct reading frequency meter. If you are seeing the direct reading frequency meter, here you are having the one vertical line and two horizontal lines are there. Okay, here we will rotate it. Here we will rotate it so as to see the dip in the CRO. So whenever we will see the dip in the CRO, there we will stop, and there whatever frequency will be the frequency that is generated from here. Okay. So here if you are seeing this range in this your direct reading frequency meter, it is from your 8 GHz to 12 GHz. Okay, microwave frequency signal means it will be around 3 or 4 gigahertz to your 200 gigahertz. You are having this is the slotted line carriage. Okay, this is slotted line. This is used for measurement of your frequency and attenuation. And in the end, you are having the detector mount. Okay, so from the detector mount, we can connect it to the CRO. If you are connected in the CRO, we can see the waveform. Or from here, we can connect it to the that is your microammeter. Okay, so in microammeter we can see that what is the current that is flowing. Okay, here we are having the beam voltage and repeller voltage.
What is the use of providing
the
beam voltage and repeller voltage?
Okay, see, beam voltage, it is providing you the constant DC voltage. Okay, and beam voltage along with the repeller voltage, it will provide the frequency which is continuous oscillation will be there. Continuous oscillation will be there. In order to have the continuous oscillation, we are going for the repeller voltage. Okay, we are getting. We have connected it to your AM. Okay, your beam voltage is say 250. Now I am going for your repeller voltage. Repeller voltage will always be negative. Repeller voltage will always be negative. Okay, so what I am doing, I am increasing that. See, when I am see, this is the maximum level I am increasing. So I am not getting any waveform. Now I am reducing it. When I am reducing, I am seeing in the CRO. Here you see that. See, I am getting some waveform and maximum I am getting. The place where I am getting maximum, there I am stopped. Okay. So I will note down this reading. Okay, so you can note down that one. Of the reflex klystron, we'll make a graph between the repeller voltage and the output power, and similarly we'll make the output power with respect to frequency. Okay, these two parameters we have to see. We are getting the maximum amplitude there around say 205, when the repeller voltage was 205. So let us assume that this is your 205 level. This is your 205 level. Here you are getting the maximum. Okay. Then you have to see that corresponding what is the output power. Okay. Remove this one and you have to connect your that DC ammeter. So in that your current will be very less, so we have to pick micro amps. There we have to select the micro amps. This voltage, this is your repeller voltage. Okay, this is your repeller voltage, and there on the CRO I am seeing. I am just increasing the repeller voltage. So when I am increasing the repeller voltage, I am not getting. Okay, then I am decreasing to so as to get the maximum amplitude. The point where I am getting the maximum amplitude, there I have stopped, and this maximum amplitude you are getting it at 205. Okay, 204 repeller voltage you are having. Okay, there you are getting the maximum amplitude. Now
where I am getting the, say, one more point I have kept. One more point. Say 215. Okay. So somewhere here. This is your 215. Okay. And similarly, I will reduce it further. These are the 3 points. Here I am getting maximum amplitude, and the both side I am getting the minimum one. Okay. At 3 points, 215, 205, and 197. So here we are seeing the current at different levels. So let me go for your 215. 215, how much is the current? Repeller voltage we have kept at 205. At 205 we are getting the maximum amplitude, and we have taken two other side where the amplitude is less. We have taken 215 and 197. So when I have connected at 215, there I am seeing that what is the current that I am getting. So what is the current value that I am getting it? 82.3. Okay, no problem. Now I will make the repeller voltage 205, and then I will see that what is the current that I am getting it. At 205, what is the value that you are getting?
196.
See, minus. All are minus only. 196.
Six.
Okay, and again I am changing it, say 197, or in terms of microamps. Okay. So this is your 0.68 milliamps. So these two are microamps, and this is the milliamps. We have to find the output power. Output power will be the product of your V and I. Power, and this is the voltage, will make a graph. So your graph will be something like this. Your graph will be something like this. Okay. So this is the voltage, and at this voltage, what is the power? So power is the product of your V into I, and that you can calculate it from here. Here, say you are having 200, 400, say 600, something like this. So from there you can calculate it, and you can identify those points. You can draw that one. 205, what is the frequency? 215, and what is the frequency at 197. Okay. At that time, we have to calculate the, we have to rotate this one, and we have to see that where we are getting the dip. Okay, dip means decrease in the amplitude. The place where we are getting the dip, there you have to stop, and from there we can calculate it. Here you are having one vertical and two horizontal. The point where these two horizontal meet with this vertical, that will be the required frequency. Okay, you just see that side. I am just rotating it at one side. Not getting this or anything, okay, anything here. Okay. Deep agating, and then this. Okay. So what I have to do, I have to adjust, and I have to see that where I am getting the maximum dip. So again I am making it. Okay, this is I am getting. So I will rotate it like this. This point. Okay. So we'll see. Okay. So if I am seeing the frequency, here you see that you are having 8.88 and 8.9 you are having. Here you are seeing, here you are seeing that you are having 8.88, and here you are having 8.9. These, okay. So this point, here you are having 8.88, and here you are having 8.9. Is it okay? 8.9 na?
Yes sir.
No. So can we say what it will be? Gigahertz, that is the frequency. That is the frequency you are getting it. Okay, now I will go for 205. When I am going for 205, there again I have to see where I am getting the dip. I am getting the dip. Okay, how? So this point, Okay, this point.
See what is happening? As I am moving, here it is, I am getting maximum, and then dip is there, and then again maximum. The point where you are getting maximum, there I will stop.
8.95.
Here only, right?
8.9, this is 8.9 and here 9.2.
9.2
means here 9.1.
0.9?
1. Okay, 0, okay, no problem.
2, 215,
okay, at 215.
Okay, so we have seen the frequency also, okay. So for this repeller voltage, what is the frequency? So if we are drawing this frequency with respect to your output power, your graph will be something like this. Your graph will be something like this, okay. So this point is your this 8.9, this point is your 8.9, this is your 8.895, this point, and this point is your 8.915, this point. Okay, so you are getting these ones. Okay, now we will go for other. So I will reduce, again I will reduce the repeller voltage. Okay, I am not getting anything, I am not getting anything. Okay, so here after 197 I am reducing it further, I am not getting anything. Again I will do the same thing, I will reduce it further and I will try to see that where I am getting. Okay, this is the maximum I am getting. Okay, maximum, this is 130. So voltage, some other point I will see. Here something is there, 122. So I am having 122 voltage, and similarly I will make it one upside, above 130 I will make it
30.
Sub point where I am having something 136. So here I am having 136 volt. So this is upper limit, this is the center, and this is the lower limit. Okay, but if you are seeing at this point, you are getting the amplitude, reduced amplitude, 136 at upper limit, 132 you are having at lower limit. So it will be this amplitude will be less, okay, it will be reduced as compared to this one. Okay, same process we have to repeat, and we have to see that one more time. Here also we are getting it. So 122, here I am not getting anything. Here I am not getting anything. Okay, I will reduce it further and I will see that whether one more is there. I am getting. So this is the maximum. The maximum. Okay, 85 volts. Okay, I am getting maximum at
82.
Okay, 82 I am getting maximum, 76. So I am having maximum at 82. I have taken 85 and I have taken 76. These three limits I have taken. And if I am drawing it here, again it will be something like this. Okay, 76 is the lower limit, 82 and 85. So we are having the, say, 1, 2, 3. These three we are getting it. These only we have to calculate. So frequency will be something like this. So this is the study of your reflex klystron characteristics. Okay. Any query? Thank you.